People have paid taxes for thousands of years, whether to local landlords for protection or to governments to fund public services, social security, and wars. But today, things are a little different. Most countries have taxes, but different rules dictate how they apply them. These rules are important because what we tax, who we tax, and how we tax shapes our societies, making some people rich while keeping others poor. Governments use tax for three main reasons. Firstly, they spend tax money, called revenue, on public services, including public transport, hospitals, schools, and the salaries of those who work in them. Secondly, they can help reduce inequality within countries by redistributing wealth. In some systems, everyone is taxed the same regardless of their means or income, with rich people paying the same portion as poor people. In others, the more you have, the more you pay. Finally, they use tax to influence behavior by making some options more attractive or affordable than others. They apply this to smoking, drinking, the car you drive, and even getting married. So how do governments collect tax? We usually think about tax on income, but if you buy, sell, inherit or own something, or if you're a company, make a profit on something, you likely have a tax to pay. Decisions around how to apply and collect tax give governments an opportunity to use tax laws to either tackle inequality or perpetuate it. Tax laws also influence inequality between countries. Not long ago, one company's economic activity tended to happen in the same place. But now, companies have many international branches and trade across borders. Approximately 80% of international trade takes place between the international branches of corporations that are actually trading with themselves. Our tax laws weren't designed to deal with this, and some companies take advantage of them to avoid paying tax. As a result, countries in the global south are being shortchanged for as much as $200 billion a year that could otherwise go to public services. This keeps the rich rich, but also prevents poorer people from accessing the services they need. The rules of the tax game have not kept pace with global financial developments, and something needs to change. Tax has long been a crucial tool for building a fairer world, both within and between countries. But what we demand of our governments determines whether taxes help alleviate inequality or make it worse. How do you think we can use tax to build a fairer world?